Let us look at Luke 19 here. We are going to look at the gospel according to Luke and the story of a man called Zacchaeus. And through Zacchaeus, we are going to expand such that we understand what we are talking about salvation and its different aspects. Praise the Lord. Everybody open their Bibles to Luke chapter 19. Everybody open their Bibles to Evangelium Secundum Lucam. The Gospel according to Luke chapter 19. And stand up with your Bible. Stand with your Bible. Let us read Luke 19. Are we here? Alright. Somebody start reading from this one. Just read this one. Anybody read this one?
He came to Jericho.
One person, read aloud.
Jesus went into Jericho and was passing through.
It's okay. Jesus came into Jericho and was doing what? He was passing through. Jesus did not mean to come and stay in Jericho. This was the story where blind Bartimaeus heard that Jesus was passing and began to shout, "Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me." And because he persisted, he was able to shout Jesus to a stop, to the extent that he received his sight. How many of us with our faith shout Jesus to a stop? Can your faith arrest Jesus tonight? As that of Bartimaeus arrested Jesus. That even though Jesus was moving, the faith of Bartimaeus said, "Jesus, stop!" And Jesus stopped for Bartimaeus. And when Jesus stopped for Bartimaeus, something negative in his life stops. If your faith can make Jesus to stop for you tonight, something negative in your life will also stop. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So Jesus was passing. Tell somebody Jesus was passing.
Jesus was passing.
There's a difference between Jericho experience and tonight's experience. What's the difference? The difference was that Jesus was passing through Jericho. Here, Jesus is not passing through Jericho. He's not passing through Cuba. He is here. There are people who say he is here. You will not go home empty-handed. You will not go home empty-handed. In the name of Jesus. Sit down, take verse 2. Sit down, read verse 2 for us.
There was a chief tax collector there, named Zacchaeus, who was rich.
Hallelujah. Salvation is in different ways. Salvation is to make a poor man rich. But somebody can be rich and be sick. Somebody can be rich and still be oppressed. That is why when we talk of salvation, we are looking at it different dimension. So this man who I used as an example today was not looking for money. He was rich. The Bible says he was rich. Somebody said he was rich. Some are rich in health. Some are rich in knowledge. Everybody is rich in one way or another. But no matter where you are rich or how rich you are, there is something you lack. And there is something you need.
And that thing you need is what Jesus will supply tonight. And that's the meaning of salvation.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, my sister, continue to read. Continue to read.
He was trying to see who Jesus was, but he was a little man and could not see Jesus because of the crowd. So he ran ahead of the crowd and climbed a cinnamon tree.
It's okay. It's okay.
Now, the first thing we look at in this teaching is the position of a man called Zacchaeus. The Bible said he was rich. When the devil wants to rob you of the totality of salvation package, he will make you to ignore where you are rich and to concentrate on where you are not rich. Am I talking to somebody?
Yes.
There are people here who are civil servants. They are working. There are others who are graduates but no work. If the devil wants to get you, he will make you to focus on the fact that you are not working, not on the fact that you are a graduate. Why are others who are trying to graduate or don't know what to pay them in school or they keep failing? Which is the best? They are praying. How do I become like this person who is a graduate? Or this graduate is crying because he does not have work. There are some people here who are married but don't have children yet, and they are thinking of stopping to serve God. Why? Where is God? He has not given the child. Why some of their ex-mates are not yet married and also going before the blessed sacrament and they are disturbing God? When will you make me like that sister? When will you make me like that brother? Will that people give me example? For what you don't have, there is something you have that you need to celebrate. So the first thing we look at is the wealth of Zacchaeus. Why I want to take note of the wealth of Zacchaeus is that Zacchaeus did not mind what he had. He went for what he did not have. Tonight, we are not going to talk about what you have. But what I want you to know is, don't let what you have rob you of what you can get tonight. So when the steward says, stand up, don't say, who is that steward? Does he know that he's talking to a professor? You are not trying to use what you have to rob you of the blessing you will get for pain. You understand the point I'm making now? So everybody has something to show. Has a feather or a blessing. Zacchaeus was very rich. So if Zacchaeus, because at the end, Jesus said salvation has come to that. If he was able to get salvation in another area, he did not have it. In spite of the area he had it, brother, don't let your beauty deceive you. Sister, don't let your beauty deceive you. Don't let your height deceive you. Don't let your money deceive you. Don't let your office deceive you. No matter what you have, there is something you do not have. Open yourself and you get it in the name of Jesus. He did not stop him. He cleared all those things and came out
of salvation. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, ma'am. You have a very good bed, a very wonderful house. You left it to come here tonight. It's already a block. Am I going to somewhere? God knows you could be sleeping, you could be resting, but you left it on. You did not mind who you are, or what you are, or what you have to rob you of coming to mingle together to seek the face of God this night. That is already a block. As the Zacchaeus thought what you wanted, tonight I prophesy, heaven will favor you.
Thank you.
the grace of this meeting, we can get into the Holy Ghost. Are you not back here? Luke chapter 19, verse 4 says, and he ran ahead of the crowd, that was ahead, and climbed up into a sycamore tree to see Jesus, because Jesus was to pass that way. At once he prayed. But Zacchaeus desperate. Zacchaeus of the initial acts. Remember, his story started by saying that this man was a very wealthy man. Now in verse 4, at once he prayed, we look at him, opening himself, forgetting about his wealth, keeping his wealth aside, and he began to run. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me, ma'am. How many times have you seen a very rich man running in the streets? Tell me. So that when Jesus says salvation has come to this man's house, you must see that he meant it. How many times have you seen a rich man running on the street? That this rich man found himself running. Nobody pursued him. But Boko Haram was not pursuing him. In case you see a rich man running to Boko Haram, there will be something pursuing him. Not just he took that decision. I must see Jesus. I must see Jesus. I must see Jesus. Someone said, I must see Jesus. So at once he prayed, Zacchaeus unusual actions. It was not a normal thing for rich men to run on the road. But Zacchaeus began to run. He did not stop there. Hey! The man said, a rich man began to climb the tree. I want you to understand Zacchaeus. He began to climb the tree in public. In the eastern area, I'm not talking about east of Nigeria, I'm talking about Israel, the eastern part of the world. What they call the oriental countries. Big men, because at that time, people, men don't wear trousers. You know, it was like that. You understand? So when a man begins to climb tree, we have what we call naughty boys. Nothing wrong, so we decide, we pretend someone is pursuing the son. They will come to that place and they will stay. And they will begin to look up. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So men did not climb trees because of naughty boys. Zacchaeus did not mind the naughty boys in town. He climbed a tree, a sycamore tree, for that matter. Just because he wanted to see Jesus, he was desperate. Pursuit is the proof of desire. Pursuit is the proof of desire. If you desire something, you pursue that thing. Hello?
Right.
You know there are some of us who have come to this PG and they are sleeping. Hello?
Yeah.
Why do you come to PG and they are sleeping? What am I supposed to do? Is sleep begins to
to disturb you. It's not devil, it's normal, it's natural. Night is meant for sleeping.
Yes.
To sleep God, there is not devil. Yes. It's normal for sleep to God at night.
Anyone who's sleeping in the night is doing a normal thing. There's no devil to buy it.
Hello?
But why do we refresh and we not sleep?
Because of our agreement. We are the ones who agreed to have a tea. That's the only reason why we must sleep. If not, night is the time to sleep. So when sleep comes, there's no devil behind it. His letter is normal. Their letter is normal. Which is why people say it's normal.
Then because of our agreement, because we agree, that is the only reason why you cannot begin to sleep. The sleep now becomes abnormal. Because we agree not to sleep.
Pactum sunt, agreement binds those who agree.
Who all agree?
Who all agree? That we have a dream. That's why we should not sleep. Yeah, no, we don't sleep, we don't sleep.
Not sleep, you are
a little. So Zacchaeus did not sleep, would not rob him of what he decided to get. Don't let sleep rob him. Desire, pursuit is the proof of desire. See, if you know that I expect something from God, when the sleep comes, stand up, walk around, pursue the sleep out of your life, out of your eyes, because we agree to have the dream. Zacchaeus ran. Zacchaeus climbed. Excuse me. Why wouldn't Jesus perform it?
A rich man doing what is unusual.